Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to talk about some problems you might be experiencing if you have an inadequately insulated cantilever. If you're not sure what that is, it's typically just an overhang that's usually at the bottom of the house, or it could be where your first and second story meet. Now, some of the problems you might be facing are air loss, obviously. Now, this area tends to be a spot that gets forgotten or missed or looked over during the construction of the house, and it's oftentimes not insulated and it's usually never air sealed. So you'll have that problem of air loss almost all the time. Now, where this really can cause issues is that space is usually an easy spot to tuck plumbing and wiring and other things like that just to get in there. It's a space that a lot of people like to use as far as builders and designers. Now, where that problem comes into play, we just talked about, you have air loss in there, so you have heat loss. So in the winter, that can cause frozen pipes. It can cause other issues like that. Obviously, it can be a gateway for pests and other things like that. It's a real big penetration in your building envelope. Now, how do you fix this? Injection or spray foam, right? That's gonna be the big question. Well, injection foam can be used in that space. You would typically fill either from the front side or from underneath the cantilever, drill in and just fill that space in. However, there can be some issues with that. Again, if there's no backer, you could just be filling injection foam all the way into the floor if there's nothing there to stop it. Again, keep in mind injection foam is designed to be an enclosed space. So can it be done effectively with injection foam? Absolutely. There are some techniques to have that done correctly. However, the safer bet that we would recommend is spray foam. It's usually best to cut an access opening, usually on the underside, depending on the accessibility of it, or on the front face of that cantilever, and spray foam in there. Make sure that's sealed off all the way around and no air gets in into the living space, into the floor. That's another thing to keep in mind. If that cantilever goes all the way through your floor, that can make your floors cold, could be contributing to that problem if you're experiencing it. So these are some things to keep in mind if you're experiencing some of these problems: frozen pipes, just dramatic air loss around this area, if you're feeling drafts around that floor, or if that floor is cold. Could be that cantilever just letting cold air in or hot air out. So keep that in mind. How to address it? Probably safest bet's gonna be spray foam. Injection foam could be an option depending on your contractor. Hope this information was helpful to you. If you have a cantilever and you're concerned maybe you're having some of these issues, drop us a comment. We'd love to help you out with that. I'm sure we can tell you the best route to go. Don't forget, subscribe to our channel so you see all of our videos. Like this video, and don't forget to ring that bell. If you guys have ever wondered what I'm holding during these videos, it's actually one of our guides, the ultimate guide to foam insulation. This one happens to be for existing homes. We also have one for pole barns, as well as one for new homes. These are also downloadable on our website. Check it out.